cPanel prices are going up again. The solo plan is going up to $26.99. That's a 50% increase from the previous increase that happened just half a year back. So at this point, the solo plan costs almost the same as the pro plan did 5 years ago. And I believe that the prices will continue to rise every year because they quite literally have a monopoly on the industry. Coming in at 93% market share with their second biggest competitor being DirectAdmin at just 5%. The biggest problem with all of the alternatives is that they offer a drastically different feeling to cPanel. Like, if you're used to this, going to the DirectAdmin panel, or the Hestia panel, or the CloudPanel, even though they're free and functionally it's almost the same, visually and from the ease of use perspective, it's a massive jump. That's why I believe that if you do need the full cPanel package of features and you want a product that feels similar to use, you got to check out sPanel. It has been in active development for the past 4+ years, where users were voting on features, suggesting updates, and the devs would add that functionality in. And recently, it came out of beta testing. It works in a similar fashion to WHM cPanel, where you have two parts to the product. The first part is your admin area, where you control the server and user accounts. You can monitor your server resource usage and even change the software that you're using. At this point, it supports Apache, Nginx, and LiteSpeed right out of the box. And for faster development, you can easily restart different services individually. There's firewall, interface, and stuff like that. Of course, you can create an unlimited amount of users for various different websites that you'll be hosting, and even allocate different resource limits to these websites. Then have full admin control over those users with the ability to suspend or ban accounts. But the core product is the website control dashboard that has a very familiar feeling if you've been using cPanel before. This is where you get your WordPress-specific functionality, emails, backups, DNS settings, security. It's actually quite nice because there's no bloat like there is in cPanel, and I've been using this on my VPS for the past year now, and even though it was kinda in beta, it still works great. It's really exciting because features are still constantly being added and the product is actively improved for free. For example, you can currently host Node.js apps from the user interface, but not Python apps. However, Python support is already added, there's just no button for it yet, but the devs are adding this in a couple of months. So currently, cPanel is $26.99 for one account and $32.99 for 5 accounts. sPanel is $9.95 for 5 accounts and $14.95 for 30 accounts, and $19.95 for 100 accounts if you're a massive enterprise. I mean, the difference in pricing is huge. If you're going for the 100 accounts, sPanel is 230% cheaper than cPanel for a product that works even better, in my opinion. One major key difference is that if you're using cPanel, you get customer support, but your users don't. Meaning, if you host a client website and they run into issues, you have to fix those issues yourself, because the client will most likely contact you directly. However, sPanel offers end-user support, meaning all users will have a live chat button at the bottom, and the sPanel support agents will help anyone with server and website related issues. Keep in mind, this does not cost extra, it's just included in every single plan. And it's a massive game changer because just by using sPanel, you're getting a support center for your web hosting business, or if you're a developer or a designer, you don't have to troubleshoot every single client problem yourself. You can offload that to the sPanel support team, and that problem never even reaches you. But there's a downside as well. sPanel only works with Rocky Linux 9 or newer, so if your VPS is running Ubuntu, like most people use, sPanel simply can't be installed. And I really don't understand this limitation from their part. Yes, Rocky Linux 9 is a powerhouse when it comes to enterprise usage, but it's nowhere near as popular as Ubuntu for simple home applications. And limiting people to use Rocky Linux 9 only is a massive L, in my opinion. You also can't install sPanel yourself. Upon purchase, the installation process is kind of pain in the ass, I'm not gonna lie. It feels like they tried to make it simpler, but in the end, it ends up being more confusing than just doing it yourself. First of all, you have to use this janky menu to input your server IP, and after purchase, there are no instructions on what to do next. You just have to know that you need to give your server login credentials to the sPanel team by opening a ticket. I mean, I've never seen this before, and I imagine this is a placeholder solution because giving your login credentials to random people for them to install software you don't know anything about on your server is a massive, massive security risk. I'd prefer there was an option to do it myself because at this point, you just got to take their word for it that it hasn't been malicious and they're not being malicious with your server. I just don't like that layer of trust. After the installation, of course, I poked around my server files. It all seemed to be in order, but I still feel violated that someone entered my private little server. This way of doing it might tie into why there's a managed version of the service as well, which is way more expensive than the unmanaged one. And honestly, I couldn't find much differences between the services. Theoretically, the managed version is supposed to provide you help with your server configuration and optimization. So instead of installing on an empty server and leaving it alone, they would look at the best practices, security, and stuff like that on your server as well. In reality, if you're looking at these web hosting options, you probably can do this work by yourself, and it will be way more fun without the unnecessary risk. And since sPanel is kinda light, requiring a minimum of 256 megabytes of RAM and one CPU core to run, with a recommended value of 2 gigabytes of RAM, if you plan to host a website alongside it, compared to cPanel's 2 gigabytes minimum and 4 gigabytes recommended values, it can be easily tested on any cheap $2 VPS to see if it's something you'd like to use and you enjoy using. That being said, I use the unmanaged version as the product is still exactly the same, and every time I contacted their support, they still provided me with full support and were really helpful in terms of troubleshooting and solving my problems, even though I didn't have the managed version. As it stands right now, I do feel it's the best cPanel alternative on the market. Same functionality, more features, and for a fraction of the cost. If you can get away with using Rocky Linux 9, this is a very potent web server management tool. And if you'd like to learn how to earn extra passive income by charging your clients for web hosting on top of your design or development services by using a VPS and a control panel just like this one, watch this video next where I outline the process in detail. Good luck hosting your websites, and I'll see you around.